Hello from San Antonio, this is Siren Tarot. Welcome back to another Pick a Card reading. Your life in 2025. There are four options for this reading. This is option one. This is option two. This is option three. And quattro, option four. As always, timestamps will be provided. Don't overthink it, just take a deep breath and make your selection. If you chose the first crystal, here's your reading. So if you chose one, you could have strong Cancer placements in your natal chart. You could have Sun, Moon, Venus, Mars, or Mercury in Cancer, or your Moon could be on an angle. For example, the first house. My Moon in Virgo is on my ascendant in the first house. So you could have prominent Moon in your natal chart. Okay. Cat Black's Golden Tarot. King of Swords, Four of Wands, Two of Cups, I can't make this up, never can recall what this deck is called. Reina de Copas, Queen of Cups. El Mundo, the world, the fixed modality. Scorpio, Leo, Aquarius, Taurus. Los Amantes, Los Enamorados, the lovers, Gemini. Two of Spades, Two of Swords, Dos de Espadas. Again, two is the number of Cancer. Queen of Hearts, Queen of Cups, Reina de Copas, again. And another two, Two of Diamonds, Two of Pentacles, Dos de Oros. So I see the theme for 2025 being a serious relationship, possibly a marriage. And this is someone you're very close to. You would think, okay, you're marrying someone, you're close. Not necessarily. This is a very close, intimate relationship. You could be soulmates, twin flames. It's definitely a spiritual connection. And that's the theme for your 2025, is this very healthy, deeply gratifying, harmonious relationship. So, if you chose pile one, you could have Sun in Cancer. Gemini rising, Moon in Virgo. That's just one possibility. And this person you're going to marry in 2025 could have Sun in Gemini, Aries rising, Moon in Scorpio. These are just possibilities. I feel like your money's going to be fine in 2025. I see you combining resources with your future spouse. So money is good, but the main takeaway, the main thing I see in this spread is a deeply gratifying, healthy relationship. So if you chose pile one, you probably know who this person is already. You're probably already in a relationship. Maybe you're planning your wedding. You could manifest this. You could meet this person in 2025. But I feel like most of you who chose pile one, you already know this person and you're already in a good relationship. Usual caveat, I'm reading for a global audience. It's not a personal reading. If it doesn't resonate at all, feel free to pick another pile. But that is what I see for pile one. Four is Aquarius, eight is Capricorn, two Cancer, six Venus. So six and four, that's 10, that's one, making 10 the number, making Leo the dominant energy. Leo's all about the love, and I see big love for pile one. Maybe you live in the South. All we're missing is the H, South. If you're in the States, you could live in the Deep South. Maybe you live in South America. Sound, you could really be into music. You could be a musician. You and this person you're going to marry, you could have this musical bond. You send each other playlists, something like that. I'm also seeing London. Stone, we're missing the E. Las Cruces, Las Vegas, Los Angeles. You and this person could have a son. You could be really big on law of attraction, law of assumption, manifestation. Could be the owner of a hair salon, or you work in a hair salon. Talons, the eagle. The eagle is the highest energetic form of Scorpio. So yeah, that's what I see for one. I hope that helps. I'm always available for private readings. All the info and client testimonials are in every box. Thanks so much for watching. Peace out. And if you chose the second crystal, here's your reading. Throat chakra problems. Okay, if you chose the second pile, you could have strong Taurus in your natal chart, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Mars, Mercury. You could have your Venus on an angle, Venus in the second house, something like that. Cat Black's Golden Tarot. When I started this channel in 2018, this was one of the only decks I had. I had this, Legend Arthurian, and Essential Tarot. That was about it. Two of Coins, those that were owes to his Cancer, the Magician, El Mago, Gemini, and Temperance, La Templanza, Sagittarius. Never can recall the name of this deck, but I love it because of the Spanish. Pentapade, a Copas, Prince, or Page of Cups. Ace to Copas, Six of Cups, Six is Venus. As to Copas, Ace of Cups. Beautiful. Ten of Hearts, Ten of Cups, Deus de Copas. Ten is Leo. Two of Clubs, Two of Wands, those de Bastos. Two again, Cancer. Four is Aquarius, Four of Hearts, Four of Cups, Quad of the Copas. Okay. For some of you, you could be getting married in 2025. That is pretty strong to have this marriage card in the first row and to have Six of Cups in the center, and then it has the Ace of Cups next to it. So you could be manifesting this really yummy, deeply gratifying relationship that leads to marriage in 2025. Excuse me. But unlike pile one, I definitely saw marriage for pile one. This doesn't have to be marriage necessarily. It could just be, what I'm really getting as I was putting the cards down, this is what popped into my head. What I'm really getting for pile two more than anything is that in 2025, you're going to cultivate, develop this deeper understanding of yourself. And that may sound boring and generic, but there are people who go from cradle to grave. They live an entire life and they never really know themselves. They don't have self-awareness. They don't have consciousness. I see a deepening of your consciousness in 2025. I see you creating intimacy with yourself. Your intuition is super sharp or sharper in 2025. You could be developing psychic gifts. Some of you could be starting a tarot channel, or your tarot channel is going to the next level. You could be getting certified with Reiki, something spiritual. So I would say, unlike pile one, the theme for pile two is really about spirituality. Your theme for 2025, spirituality and a deepening of your self-awareness. Maybe previously you were easily fooled, easily manipulated. You lacked self-confidence. You didn't really know where you began and other people ended, or vice versa. You may have had a pattern in your life of toxic codependency and a pattern of just giving your power away. But that's not going to be the case in 2025. I see you growing your power, growing your strength, really figuring out who you are and figuring out what it takes to fill your own cups. Okay. I see you connecting with your higher self, maybe nurturing your inner child, putting to rest trauma that you've been carrying around for years. I finally see release and liberation in 2025. And for some, again, you could be manifesting this marriage, but it's not as strong as it was for pile one. Even though, again, that's strong to have Ten of Cups in the first row, I'm looking at all of these cards, putting all of these cards together. Okay. I feel like if you chose pile two, you've always been pretty adept at so-called 3D stuff. You can get a job, you can hold it down, you can accumulate, you're good with money, you're smart with money. But in 2025, you're going into the 5D, okay, the spiritual realm. You're getting stronger in the 5D in 2025. So you could have Sun in Taurus, Mercury in Gemini, Cancer rising, Moon in Cancer. That's just one possibility. Four is Aquarius, Six is Venus, Ten is Leo, Five is Mercury, Gemini, Virgo. For some of you, it could be really deep. You're getting into channeling. You can channel. You might be a medium. Could be a really intense psychic awakening in 2025. Okay. 11, that's 2, Cancer. So, 2 and 4, that's 6, Venus. Yes, there's a lot of love for you in 2025, but most importantly, I see this deep love for yourself. Well, we don't have much for letters, do we? Shug Avery, the color purple. Lex. Learning how to treat yourself, learning how to love yourself. See, the fact that we don't really have any vowels other than you, I see the vowels as feminine, I see consonants as masculine. Going really deep here, deeper than I usually go, but I see you taking the masculine elements of your chart and protecting your feminine energy. For example, I've got Mars in Capricorn. In my chart, Mars and Capricorn in the fifth. And although technically, yes, Capricorn is feminine, that's a very masculine placement because Mars is exalted. Mars is super strong in Capricorn, especially in the fifth house, especially being potent, 4 degrees, that's potent. So I see my Mars as being very protective of my first house Virgo moon. Okay, that's how I've always seen it. I've seen it as my Mars defending my moon. Because, like a lot of people, I didn't have the best childhood. I had a lot of problems my first 7 years. There were no boundaries. Boundaries were not respected. And now, at the age of 51, I am really, really good at defending myself. Not allowing people to manipulate or trample my boundaries. And so that's what I see you coming into in 2025. You're protecting yourself. You're protecting your inner child. You're being really strong and smart with boundaries. So yeah, that's what I see for pile 2. Hope that helps. I do this full time. I am always available for private readings. All the info, including client testimonials, are in every box. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out. And if you chose 3, the light is not so great. Yesterday, the sun was blinding, and now it's overcast. But this is a gorgeous orange crystal. And if you chose 3, you could have a really strong Mars. I was just discussing my Mars in the second pile. I've got one of the best Mars you can have. I've got Mars in Capricorn. It's exalted in Capricorn. It's in the fifth house. So you could have a strong Mars in your chart. You could have Mars in Capricorn. I'm really getting more Mars in Scorpio, Mars in Aries. But Mars in Scorpio, Mars in Aries in the first house, Mars in Capricorn. I see you being very strong and healthy with a very strong libido if you chose 3. Okay. Starting with Cat Black's Golden Tarot. I don't recall buying this deck. It's the deck that I've had the longest. I had to have gotten it on Amazon in 2013. Hermit, El Ermitaño, Virgo. Ten of Swords, Deus, Deus, Spatas. Ten is Leo. Seven of Wands, that is the Bastos. Seven is Pisces. Never can recall what this deck is called. I love it because of the Spanish. No más. Deus de Bastos, Ten of Wands. Cinco de Copas, Five of Cups, Five is Mercury, Gemini, Virgo, and El Mago, the Magician, Gemini. Strong Mercury for pile three. Four of Hearts, Four of Cups, Cuatro de Copas, Four Aquarius. So we have the Leo, Aquarius axis, another ten. Ten of Hearts, and the Cups, Deus de Copas. Two of Clubs, Two of Wands, those the Bastos. So there's no way to sugarcoat this. I do not specialize in sugarcoating. I suck at sugarcoating. It looks like 2025 is going to be quite intense and dramatic for you. It's going to be pretty much a hell ride. There's that saying, what doesn't kill us makes us stronger. You are going to develop the strength of a samurai warrior in 2025. You are going to be formidable. This is not for the faint of heart. And it's my personal belief, I could be wrong, but it's my personal belief that we don't come down to planet Earth for a carnival or a circus. We don't come down here to just accumulate wealth and have fabulous, easy experiences. I don't know. It's my belief that we come down here to get stronger somehow. And what we do with that strength on the other side in the 5D, I have no idea. But I can only speak from my experience, and I've had a very challenging life in many ways. I've survived some things that some people could not survive, and I've written books about it. I'm working on a book right now. So I see you being tested. I see your strength being tested greatly in 2025. For some, this could be a personal loss. This could be a relationship that ends. It could end in death. It could end in separation. Some of you could be going through a divorce in 2025. For others, it could just be that something happens in 2025 that you're not expecting. Something comes out of the blue, and you find this reserve of strength you did not know that you had. I can use so many examples from my life, but this reading is not about me. It's about what can you expect of 2025. But when I use examples from my life, that's kind of as a frame of reference. So I'm not just spouting off generic stuff. I'm anchoring it in the real, in the specific. I'll use one example for my life, okay? I joined the Army. I left for basic training in December of 1994. I went to Fort Jackson, South Carolina. And people who hear that I was in the Army, they can't really believe it because I don't seem the type at all. And I'm not the type. I'm not the type to join the Army. But I was kind of running out of options. I had tried a lot of other things that didn't work, so I thought, what the hell? I'll join the Army. And it was bad. It was really bad, but it was good. It was bad, but it was good. It was mixed. It was Saturn and it was Mars. It definitely wasn't Neptune. There was no delusion. I was tested severely. When I got to the reception battalion, I couldn't do a single push-up, so I had to stay at this I had to stay at reception battalion in this company called Fitness Training Company. And I had to get stronger. I had to do the push-ups. It's pretty basic. If you can't do the push-ups, you can't go to basic training. It's pretty black and white. There's no shades of gray to that. Anyway, I got sick. I lost more than half the blood in my body. I had menorrhagia. Excuse me. So it was really intense and it was really bad. I almost died, but I didn't. I was pushed in ways that I never anticipated. And even though I got a medical discharge, I didn't go on to have a military career. It was an experience that I'm grateful for. So, we have all this darkness, we have all this negativity, but we have this brightness. It doesn't get much brighter than Ten of Cups. Technically, traditionally, going by the Little White Book, it is a marriage card. But I don't see you getting married in 2025. I see you going through a lot, probably the first half, and then things get better around June, July. There is light at the end of the tunnel. But you're developing your strength. You're being pushed. You're being tested by the universe. And you're going to come out on top. Okay. For some of you, it's something as simple. It's not that dramatic. It's something as simple as cutting certain people out of your life. People who have abused you, people who have taken advantage of you, exploited you, people who have trampled your boundaries, similar to pile two. No more of that bullshit. You're cutting out the riffraff. And it's hard, it's lonely when you cut people out of your life, especially family members. It's very, very hard cutting your own family out of your life if you come from a small family like mine. But you get to a certain point in your life, I'm 51, where you just have no more tolerance for bullshit or abuse. And so you're getting stronger. You're learning how to take care of yourself, how to defend yourself. You're putting in the hard work. And if you're doing something in 2025, like starting a tarot channel, it's not going to be just overnight success by any stretch of the imagination. You know, I started this channel November 2018, and my success has been very mediocre, very moderate compared to a lot of other readers who have 100,000 plus subscribers, you know. So if you have prominent Saturn in your chart, which I do have in mine, the overnight success thing, that's not going to be a thing for you. Anything you get, you're going to have to work your ass off for it. So I see you putting in hard work in 2025. This is not the energy of someone who's just going from party to party. Excuse me. Closing down the bars, hanging out with friends, having a lot of sex, getting on a plane, going to Fiji, getting on a plane, going to Paris. This is buckling down, doing the hard work, eating your metaphorical or maybe literal peas and carrots. I'm basically living on green smoothies, not because I want to, because I have to, because I'm anti-big pharma. And so there's this book, Books, The Goodbye to Lupus Protocol, and that's what I'm following. And I'm claiming optimal health for myself. I've been through it in 2024, and I see you going through it in 2025. Could be a health scare. It could be a lot of things, but there is light at the end of the tunnel. And you're going to manifest this victory. You're going to manifest this optimal life, but it's not going to be overnight. It's going to be a lot of work. I see it easing up probably mid-2025, June, July. Things get a lot better. But you got to hang in there and do whatever it takes to get pumped up, to inspire yourself, you know. Watch something like 8 Mile. I don't know. my Leo boyfriend at the time, he was kind of disturbed when I told him I had watched 8 Mile 3 times in a row in one night. He said, "That can't be healthy, can it?" But whatever inspires you, whatever pumps you up, look to someone else who has gone through something similar and they've triumphed. They've succeeded. Find a spirit animal. But this is intense. This is interior. This is not exterior. This is not you getting help from the outside. This is you learning how to help yourself. This is very strong, stoic, independent energy for pile three. You're going to be a spiritual badass. You already are, but it's going to be shown. It's going to be evident after you survive 2025 that you're the heavyweight champion of badassery or something. Okay. Bottom line, you're not to be fucked with. Looking at the stove clock, it's 4:22. Make a wish. That's 8, right? Yeah, I can do math. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Who do we appreciate? Pile 3, the badass. Capricorn, Saturn. 4 is Aquarius. 5 is Mercury, Gemini, Virgo. 9 is Aries. 2 is Cancer. 7 is Pisces. There's no Pisces. There's no delusion. There's no Neptune to 2025 for pile 3. Okay, 9 Aries, yeah. 9, 10, 11. So 2, that's interesting. 2 is the dominant number, which is Cancer. You're learning how to parent yourself. If you didn't have the best parents, you're learning how to parent, how to nurture, how to defend yourself in 2025. You are definitely not a fake. You're all about the authenticity. Neo. That's a Matrix reference, isn't it? I tried to watch the first Matrix movie in 1999. I walked out after 15 minutes because I was laughing so hard people were staring at me. I was with my Aquarian brother and we couldn't. So I'm not a Matrix fan, but Neo is one of the names, isn't it? Anything else? Okay, in MBTI terms, FE, that's extroverted feeling. Probably a lot of you who chose pile 3, you're not FE doms. I'm definitely not an FE dom. I'm an FI dom. That's introverted feeling. So FE doms, they can come across fake. They're trying to appeal to various people. They're like the peacemakers. They're like the miscongeniality of MBTI. That ain't me, and it's probably not you either if you chose 3. So, Alaska. Yeah, that's what I see. That's what I have. I hope that helps. I do this full time. I'm always available for private readings. All the info, including client testimonials, is in every box. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out. And if you chose 4, here's your reading. So if you chose 4, you could have strong Aquarius in your natal chart, Sun, Moon, Venus, Mars, Rising. You could have a lot of stuff in the 11th house, the house of Aquarius. You could have Uranus. Some people say Uranus. Some people say Uranus. I say Uranus. You could have a Uranus that makes a lot of aspects. Cat Black's Godin Tarot. That is such a pretty stone. I love that. Wheel of Fortune, Sagittarius. 10 of Cups, Deus de Copas, 10 is Leo. Ace of Swords, the blazing sword of truth, Deus Spatos. Never can recall the name of the stack. I love it because of the Spanish. Uno más. Seis de oros, six of pentacles, six is Venus. El Loco, the Fool, Aquarius. Another four, can't make this up. Cuatro de oros, four of pentacles. Yeah, strong Aquarius vibes for four. And another 10, 10 Leo, 10 the diamonds, 10 the pickles, 10 the oros, queen of spades, queen of swords, reina de espadas, and jack of diamonds, knight of pentacles, caballo de oros. Finally, success after a long period of a lot of trial and error. A long period of mediocrity, a long period of deep dissatisfaction. You're coming into your own, you're coming into your power in 2025, and it's glorious. You're getting a kind of revenge on all the haters and the naysayers, people who doubted you, people who didn't believe in you. You're coming out on top in 2025. You put in the hard work, and it's paying off in 2025. I see you being flush. I see you being financially successful. For some of you, could be getting married. This has popped up in almost every pile. I'm seeing marriage for a lot of fuckers in 2025. We do have two marriage cards. We have the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles. So for some of you, you could be getting married. Not everyone wants to get married. Not everyone is in a position where they can get married. So keep the usual caveat in mind. This is a pick a card reading. It's not a personal reading. I'm reading for a global audience, so there's no way it's going to be everyone's situation. But for some of you, yeah, you're going to get married, and it's going to be seemingly out of the blue. Like all of a sudden you're jetting off to Vegas or Hawaii, Fiji, some damn place, and you're having this unexpected wedding. But it's not, I don't feel like it's someone that you just met or that you just meet in 2025. This is someone you've had kind of an on-again, off-again thing with. It's been sideways. It's been everything. So if you are getting married in 2025, this is someone you have a lot of history with. This is not a new person, okay? This is someone who showed you a lot of resistance. Historically, there could be an age gap. You could be a few years older, and this person just was very cautious, very slow to commit. But finally, it's coming together for some of you in 2025. Okay? Others, you're starting your own business, and I feel like it's going to be brick and mortar. I'm not getting online. I'm not seeing someone starting a tarot channel or starting to sell on Etsy. I'm seeing a brick and mortar. You're opening a shop, you're opening a store in 2025. Excuse me. And your risk, the risk that you take in March, that just popped into my head. The risk that you take in March is really going to pay off in a big way. So this is the money pile. Yeah, there's a possibility of marriage. Maybe you marry into wealth, or you combine resources with someone who's really good with money. But out of all the piles that I've done, this one screams money. A lot of money for pile four. Huge success. You took a risk. You're taking a risk. It pays off. So, yeah, if you chose four, you could have Sun in Aquarius, Capricorn rising, Moon and Sagittarius. That's just a possibility. Two is Cancer, six is Venus, eight is Capricorn, four is Aquarius, 10 is one, that's Leo. So one and two. Oh, three. That's awesome. Three is the luckiest number. Jupiter, Sagittarius, you're going to be lucky in 2025. But there's that saying, the harder you work, the luckier you are. Yeah, this is not the energy of someone who just has a horseshoe up their ass. It's not like the universe is just waving a magic fairy wand and you have all the success. You've worked your ass off. And so it seems like luck. It seems like you're especially favored. People who don't know any better would say, oh, must be great being you. You've definitely put in the work and it's paying off. So yeah, good for you. Oops. Some of you are singers. You like to sing. You'll be singing on a stage in 2025. We don't have any vowels. I see the vowels as feminine, the consonants as masculine. This is a very masculine year for you. 2025, it's a fire year, kind of like the dragon year. Okay. So extroverted success, obvious success. You're just killing it. You're kicking ass in the 3D in 2025. Dancing with the stars, really? You're going to go on dancing with the damn stars. Okay. Finland, you will show your fangs in 2025. You will bite. You will protect yourself. I've said that a lot for a lot of the piles. You'll really be protecting yourself. You'll be defending your territory in 2025. I just see massive success, okay? New Hampshire. I see Washington, D.C., Tennessee. Yeah, I trust you get the gist. That's what I see for four, and that does conclude this Pick a Card reading. Thank you all so much for watching, liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. Sending you all massive love and light from San Antonio.